All right, thank you for staying with us. It's TVC Breakfast. We're looking at the new outbreak of avian flu that's affected, well, reportedly some 26 states. But our guest in the studio, Taiwo Adeoye, who is the president of Animal Science Association of Nigeria, says, no, that's a bit exaggerated. So now, but well, so how many states now have been affected by this avian flu? And we hear that it's a new strain. Maybe you should talk about that further for us.
That's what the two states that have heard that there has been outbreak,
Plateau
and Kano, they are two different strains.
Okay.
Those are the information reaching me. And like I said to you, even Lagos State, there is a particular axis of Lagos State that have been known for outbreak of bird flu. Mm. And we have not had any report from that area, even till this morning that I'm coming. And I've just called somebody who informed me also that the program in Lagos State to sensitize farmers to get themselves prepared with biosecurity that you always talk about, so that you shield yourself from it. And how do we control that? How do we prevent it? It's just vehicular movement and all that you need to do. We call it biosecurity, put in place. So that program will be taking place today at Johnson Agri.
All right,
farmers should be able to attend.
Yes, let's understand. So just Plateau State and Kano State, is where the bird flu is confirmed in Nigeria right now.
How many birds have been affected so far? Do we know?
Yeah, the report also tells me that about 3.5 million to date. Mm. So, but I wouldn't know what time.
Plateau State alone, about 11.
That's massive.
No, not just now. Maybe for now, okay. All over.
Okay.
You know, this thing has been about this time, January time. Like I told you some times ago, the white birds come through that axis, really, that are carrier. Of this,
the northern
Kano, that is the root of this white ball. They are carriers of this virus, and that's why we tell people get yourself prepared. Then you said, why is it a refugee in Nigeria?
Every, like every year,
you say, I wouldn't want to. Nigeria is still good in curbing outbreaks, really, even from the Ebola issue. You will know that we are giving credit for that. They all over the world, you still see it coming in China, you still see it in there. So it is a thing that will come, but you get yourself prepared for it and preventive measure through biosecurity, like I said. Stop moving. Our farm is not a show-off place where you just allow anybody to come into farms. So you need to prevent vehicular movement. Another. For now, farmers should prevent people who are coming to their farm to buy product not to enter, or when they are coming, we make sure that you take precautions like buffing the vehicle, make sure that on our farm you have all the disinfectant that people can use, let them enter into the those chemicals, let me put it that way, solution that have been prepared, the vehicle will move in and all that. Just take preventive
measures. But is there some kind of monitoring agency to ensure that some of these measures are actually in place,
whether there's
an outbreak or not?
Yeah, I believe from that is government that can do it anyway. Mm-hmm. But more importantly, even if there's no any measure, the poultry farmer should be careful because it's your investment. You get what I'm saying? So it's your investment. And today, the value of a chicken that is lean is not less than about 5,000 when you put everything into place, the cages and everything. So the value of a bird is not less than about 5,000. So you should be doing what is needful. No, somebody should not be telling
you
what
to do. Well, when it comes to doing the needful, I guess if there are no laws or there is no regulatory agency with the force of power, sometimes there's a limit to which a normal farmer can go. There's just a limit because
sometimes
the customer can say, what do you mean by that? The customer will barge into your wherever you say, okay, fine, you have to, there's a barricade or there's the end point, you wait there, we'll bring this to you. Any customer can violate that. And how do you prosecute? You know, so when there is no force of authority where you report such cases.
You have the authority of your farm. I will give you a scenario.
Yes.
We had to flush our borehole, and the people that came, we told them to pass through the water bath. And the guy who felt he was educated enough was saying that, no, this thing will itch my body. And I went in there, dipped my leg into it. But he refused. And I said, you should leave. And he left. So I looked for another person. So it's you that will enforce it more. And looking at your investment, and let me say, there is a particular department that is responsible for that.
For that, okay.
They can go on for surveillance wherever there is outbreak or there is any way. They do that. That is veterinary department of any state or the federal. They should go out and also report outbreaks. Now, many people will not want to report outbreak now because of the incentives that government is giving. They only want to give incentives on 3,000. If you have 100,000 bucks and the government says they can only they can only compensate you on 3,000. Then you don't want to report if at all there's anything. And that is the danger which you need to look at. There may be outbreaks and somebody will not report it because government will not do anything about it. What I learned now is that they are saying, okay, go for insurance. How many insurance companies want to insure farms? They feel that the risk is too much. Whereas it's not so. In developed climate, you see insurance company coming to your head. Only the Nigerian Agric Insurance Company is available now.
We have Nike. All right, more perspectives for you on this particular issue now. Poultry farming has to do with rearing birds such as chicken, turkey. Did you have one?
I used to.
Duck and geese for the purpose of farming meat or eggs for food.
Yeah, poultry birds need a lot to survive, like enough space, water, light and heat, feeders and vaccines, food among others. And of these elements, food and vaccines make up the major expenses.
Now, many poultry farms in Nigeria feed their birds with meals rich in maize, soya beans, fish and other supplements. And our poultry feed accounts for about 70% of the total cost of poultry farming, while maize accounts for more than 50% of the requirement for food or feed production.
Now, findings by TVC Breakfast reveal that the cost of poultry feed has increased, forcing many farmers to find alternative ways of feeding their birds. And some poultry farmers have either reduced the quantity of required nutrients in the food or reduced the number of times the birds eat in a day.
Now, some of the poultry farmers have also cut down on their stock of birds to make ends meet. Now, the foreign exchange crisis, yes, that's there, is not helping out as most of the vaccines and medicines for the birds are imported into the country. Another problem that is plaguing the poultry sector is the recurring cases of bird flu in some parts of the country. Of course, that's why we're talking about this morning, a disease that spreads among birds and can also affect humans. All right, let's just put that on hold. There's so many challenges here. Talking about poultry feeds, you have a situation where some poultry farmers actually reduce the quantity or maybe the quality of food or feed,
just you know,
for the birds and all of that. There's a forex wahala, if I'm allowed to use that word. So how do you, as I mean, you are a poultry farmer, you would understand the difficulties that you're facing now. Shed more light on that.
Thank you. If a poultry farmer is trying to cut costs by reducing feed, he's only giving himself problems. Because I mentioned it here, garbage in is garbage out. And whatever you give to the chicken is what they will produce. So it's not this time around, with all the challenges, efficiency is necessary. And then you cannot do penny-wise, pound-foolish. It will not help you in your enterprise, in your business. It will not be profitable. Because if you try to reduce feed, it will show from your factory, which is the board. I always represent the chicken as a factory. So it will show. The production will drop. It's just like a you that is not hitting well. Disease will come
visible.
In. So it will be visible. The number of eggs will drop, mortality will result in, and will come in, and all that. Then you lose at it. So this is the time to even be more efficient in your approach to this business. Now, I agree that the cost of feed is not even 70% again. It's far beyond that because of the cost of materials. The only problem that we have also with the material is the quality of the material being used. Now, a lot of suppliers may be trying something.
Well, when you say material, exactly what you
mean? Maize that you mentioned, soya. The prices are on the high side. And then when we look at the situation in the country, the value of our naira, it has allowed people to come from neighboring country to come and pick our own grains. It's cheaper for them to come and buy here. You know, the federal government initially predicted there will be famine of cereals before they start changing some things again. That thing is there. Because one of the major challenges we have is that the cost of, even as it is high here, because maize now is about 150 naira per ton. I mean, 150,000 per ton. Soya is about 150,000 per ton. Even at this time, when we're supposed to have the lowest, because, you know, we just came from our first period. And now we are still having the price about now. What will now happen by the time we go to April, May, and all that? We cannot predict. And that, the cumulative effect of all this is that some farmers have closed. You know, I said it here in December.
Yeah, you said it the last time. Yeah. All right, we'll come back to this. Now let's go on another break and we come back. But this time we'll be going out on TVC Entertainment. Viewers there can continue with TVC Breakfast on TVC Nigeria on Concert Channel 190 and DSTV Channel 418.
Also, Go TV 45 and ACTV 510. Stay with us.
Right, if you're just joining us, you're watching TVC Breakfast, and we have Taiwo Adeoye with us. He's the president of Animal Science Association of Nigeria. And we've been talking about challenges and fresh challenges facing poultry farmers. And he's a poultry farmer himself, and he has been enlightening us as far as these are concerned.
And now, I said something a bit troubling when we went on that break.
I was talking about vaccines.
Yes.
Now, we have a veterinary research institute in VOM, close to Jos, that's in Plateau State. When it comes to vaccines, do we have to import vaccines from across the world?
Yeah, everything that is affecting the nation is also touching the area of agriculture, especially livestock subsector. We used to have production of few vaccines in Jos, VOM. I remember even as a student, they have some quantity of vaccines that could.
Now, we have a veterinary research institute in VOM, close to Jos, that's in Plateau State. When it comes to vaccines, do we have to import vaccines from across the world?
Yeah, everything that is affecting the nation is also touching the area of agriculture, especially livestock subsector. We used to have production of few vaccines in Jos, VOM. I remember even as a student, they have some quantity of vaccines that could. But then, how many poultry do we have in Nigeria? Even then, at that time, they can only produce certain vaccines in Nigeria. Maybe the one we call Lasuta, Gomboro. And then we were even told, even in school, encouraged to use local vaccines.
Okay.
Where is the availability of it today? How many can they? About 3 weeks ago, I tried to reach somebody in form who had worked with me before to have a way of linking up with them. What there are some they cannot produce, like Marek vaccines. They were not producing it. They were not producing the 3-in-1, we call it 3-in-1, ND, IBD, EDS, and all that. They were not producing all those ones. Even the one they can produce, are they still producing to what quantity?
So how does the non-availability of these vaccines affect the...
It predisposes birds to danger. The possibility of birds being attacked with disease is high now. I was discussing with you that late December, early January, there is a particular vaccine that was so scarce, not in terms of money now. Even farmer will not mind, at least to protect his. You don't get to see it. It's not available. And that is the, when we are looking at those challenges, is because of the cost of importation. The forex situation has affected that. So now, the importers, most of the importers are no longer bringing that. I mean, bringing facts inside.
Yeah, you were telling us that over a year and a half,
we registered about 21 products with NAFDAC from our company. And the only one that we are only bringing now is the only fascinator injector and then another product for water fascination. So the cost, then when we bring it, because we bring product from Germany, from US and South Africa. But when you now bring the product in with the cost, farmers are also looking for cheap product to reduce cost of production. And I said earlier, some of these things may not work well. What happens also is the quality of the inputs that we are using. Mm-hmm. Something happened even in human recently. A member of my church had the son had problem and they were using drug for 5-6 days. Nothing happened because of the kind of drug. Mm-hmm. So we have such problem too. I want to select my own product to use because there are a lot of this product that are not up to standard.
All right. Now from the bird flu reported in Nigeria, we understand neighboring countries are trying to take precaution and they are even trying to close borders.
Yeah, not allowing
not to import birds from Nigeria. But tell us, how much of Nigerian grown birds or poultry products are sent out to these neighboring countries?
Majorly, the only thing I know that goes out very well now is egg. And I mentioned it here the other time to, in those days, even Benin, Republic of Benin, Cameroon, but more to the through the north, far north.
Okay.
Niger, Mali, and all that. Especially when the insurgents have been able to, Nigeria have been able to tackle the insurgency. So, but eggs go through that. Then processed chicken. And the processed chicken, we are not even having enough to. So, those who really package processed chicken meat in Nigeria are few. We have few companies doing that. And because they are not even able to, they are not able to meet the demands now. Some of them are going into a program called Algroa Scheme. That is, they tell farmer, produce, rear this chicken for us. We will buy from you and process to meet the market demand. It's not that the market is so huge. It's because people are not just eating. Maybe because of the take home. Let me put it that way. The take home of people.
It's not taking anybody home.
It's not taking
like. So how does that affect Nigeria's protein
intake.
Yeah,
we are not taking that.
That is why. That is why you see a lot. Deficiency right now.
Yeah, that is why you see a lot of people going to the hospital.
Wow.
I look at the situation in the country one day. I call people around me, the guards, the drivers, and how are they surviving with the minimum wage of 18,000 and the escalation of all the cost of materials? Let's just imagine.
And so South Africa now has just increased its minimum wage to $200 and something.
It's going to
be
a kind of luxury. But then,
which it shouldn't be.
Then ignorance has been killing some people in Nigeria. Do you know that an egg from the farm now, a crate of egg is 900 to 890 to
1,000
from the farm, farm gate price.
Okay, okay,
but
okay,
you
okay,
won't get it that way. They buy from the farm between 890, 900 to 950. But even then, that is not juicy for farmers really when you look at the total cost of the production.
Yes.
And now right now the price is even coming down. I will explain why that is happening.
Okay.
Now.
Mm-hmm.
The price is also trying to come down now because, what I said, the purchasing power of people, then we are approaching the heat period. The people that comes to buy from the farm are going to the north because of the heat. They cannot store the egg for a long time. So they want to buy the quantity that will be okay for maybe within the period indeed they will sell so that the government gets spoiled and they lose their money. So we always experience such a thing. It is because many farmers have sold chicken. That is why it's not that the price just jumped up. The price moved from 750 to 950, really. But when you look at the cost of production, it's also going high and higher every day.
Does this bird flu affect eggs?
No.
Not in any way?
No, not in any way. Even your chicken, you told people the other time, once it's, the way we heat here, we boil and overboil at times. doesn't affect
you. I'm glad you talk about that. Because you hear, you know, older people, elderlies, you know, actually say, look, what's all this talk about bird flu? Yeah. This thing has always been there.
We
cook this thing and we just consume and nothing happens.
Exactly. They talk about this, just cook it well and eat.
It's a zoonotic disease, really,
that
can be transferred from animal to...
Yeah, I was going to ask about
in,
that.
In handling and all that. So those are the areas in which, and if you look at it in Nigeria, I think there was only one case at in Lagos here. I can't remember now the details that was reported then that has been from animals to man.
Okay.
Nigeria, we are still good in some areas. We always refer to Ebola, and even this one, once you take the precautions, you find out that you'll be
okay. For the benefit of our viewers who don't know exactly what this bird flu looks like, how do you know if a bird, because I mean, if you go to the market and you want to buy chicken,
there are signs.
How do you know if
even farmers may not know, except you are training that thing.
Oh,
there are signs and symptoms that you see, and there could be a conflicting report there if you are not careful. If you are if you are not a specialist in it, like veterinarians, there is at times there what we call Newcastle.
Okay.
I don't know what the old word called
that. Not Newcastle in the
UK. No. Okay. Newcastle disease. Let me say Newcastle disease. Newcastle disease may have similar symptom that is close to bird flu. So it takes, in fact, it needs confirmation, laboratory confirmation,
for
you to say this is exactly what has happened.
Okay. So what are the primary symptoms?
You see birds dying in their numbers.
Okay.
And that one too, it depends on age. Because if it is Gomboro, you can have Gomboro, and the first day you record like certain few percentage. The third day, the percentage of mortality will just, then the third day comes down.
The Gomboro you talk about, is it a disease?
It's a disease. It's a disease chicken? Among chicken, okay. But it's just within the lower age, young age of birds.
Now, when you see some birds defeathered, you know, in some parts of the body, is it anything to worry about?
Because old age, that is what even people in the eastern area love. Yeah, the feathering is as a sort of old age of the birds.
Okay.
When birds are getting old, they shed their feathers.
How about watery stooling? Sometimes it's too.
That one is not particular to any disease.
Okay.
And let me just say here,
we're trying so hard to know exactly what the symptoms are.
Let me just say here that many a times. All the mortality on farms are not purely due to pathologic the problems.
Okay.
It could be nutritional.
Oh.
For instance, okay. And that is why I keep telling people, like professionals. Recently, somebody went to a farm and said, "Your birds are not laying big eggs. It's lysine methionine problem." And they went to the laboratory to do the analysis of lysine methionine for protein analysis. And I laugh. You see, there could be, many a times, there could be, but that's why professional nutritionist is that is it. There could be nutritional problem.
Mm.
So the watery feces that you are talking about could be nutritional.
Mm. Or watery stuff dripping from the bird's mouth.
If that is the case, it could be pathological,
okay.
That which is respiratory.
Okay.
Respiratory disease, upper respiratory, where you have discharge and all that, then there are medication antibiotics like human being that you can use too for that. It's only what you cannot cure is viral disease.
Mm.
Bacterial disease, you can cure those ones. I mean, you can use, and more importantly, our own kind of training as animal scientists is preventive first. Just your nutrition, let it be okay. Your management, let it be okay. Take precaution in your biosecurity. When you do all that, it's just like human. To the glory of God, I have not been to hospital for a long time. So, and I think similar to you.
Of course.
So when you take precaution, you've always been here in the morning. So, but if you don't take precaution, then some things may happen.
Yes.
All right,
okay.
We have to certainly come to the end right now. Taiwo Adeleye, President of Animal Science Association of Nigeria. Thanks for coming on the program.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. And it's good to know that it's not as bad as is being reported.
Yeah, I'm glad to hear that it's just two states.
Not 26 states. So no cause for alarm, but that's not to say that you should not be careful.
And besides that, if you're cooking a bird to eat, cooking meat, cook it very well.
Cook it well.
Exactly. Let's go on a break and we come back again. Stay with us.